Lovely.
Thank you.
Paul, can I?
Thank you.
やっと5000円です。
ベストシンカーの
ベストシンカーの
No, this is the Niger. Meu, me está aqui.
Benzo.
Benzo. Meu, me está aqui.
How are you doing, sir?
How are you doing?
I'm fine, sir.
You see.
That one.
no problem.
I
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Anything else, sir? Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm sending them. He sent off to our search share of Facebook. Just now, you said?
Yeah.
Where do you want? That was my boy, man.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand the latter day upon the earth. And though after skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh I shall see God. Whom I shall see for myself, my eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and certain we carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Pleasant morning to everyone. My condolences to the immediate family of one Junior Patrick Allen, better known as Nellis. Let us all sing the first hymn together, please. Be thou my guardian and my guide, and hear me when I call. Let not my slippery footsteps slide, and hold me, lest I fall. Be thou my guardian and my
Yeah. are to sing, and our things are strong, to the Lord we watch within, and save my soul from wrong. Give me thanks and praise, O blessed Lamb, for the life of one junior Lord, who has now departed, blessed Jesus. We pray that all is well with his soul, that he has made peace, O blessed Lamb, and thou wilt find a mercy in thy heart, that thou shalt forgive him, blessed Lord, of all sins conscious and unconsciously committed. Grant him an entrance, blessed Lord, unto the gates of paradise, where he shall sit in the company of saints for the great resurrection morn. Send forth, O Lord, thy Holy Spirit, thy angels, thy saints and prophets, to look upon those he has left behind and comfort them along this journey. But let us all be reminded, Lord, that death one day will come to us all, and thus we must make our call and our election sure with thee, in accordance to thy holy will. My God and my Redeemer, remember them, O blessed Jesus, we who are left behind. Let us now make our part before thee. Pray, O blessed Lord, with our pure and clean hands today, that we will be found, and we will be found worthy too, before thy presence, Jesus, my God and my Redeemer, as you have taught us all to say, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters, he restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy Lord, and thy staff to comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall fall into the place of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Everybody fall short of the glory of God, merciful Jesus. Remember him, thou peace of peace. Have mercy on him, my God and our Father. Leave him not to himself alone. Get to that journey again, merciful Jesus. Ah, Father and God, remember again, merciful Jesus. Remember his children again, my God. Talk to them one by one. Them know his God and God alone. You can create and you can destroy. Remember Nigel again, my God. The man's servant in a particular manner. Remember his children again, merciful Jesus. Bring them up in Christ again, my God and our Father. Manners and respect again, merciful Jesus. All the family again, merciful Lord. Bundle them like a bundle that can never be broken again, Jesus. Ah, my God and our Father. One more must I tell you again, Jesus. Remember the beggar by the wayside. Let them beg and receive. The prisoner again, Master God and friend. Right here, a bloom of salvation. The guilty one and the not guilty one again, merciful Jesus. I bring myself as a living sacrifice, my God and our Father. Keep me the way you wanted to be again, Jesus, Lord. You know my mission and my accomplished, Master God. Ah, merciful Jesus. You know my days again, Master God. Let me my days, Lord, be so pleased. My home again, merciful Jesus. One more time, I tell you, I don't know, Master. Ask him to walk and talk with me again, merciful Jesus. The place I walk upon me to be, Master God. Let me do it in justice and in truth again, merciful Jesus. Leave me again, not to myself alone. Thank you.
Best condolence on passing of our brother, Junior, or as he was referred to me. On my arrival, I'm going to read you little tonight, sir. It's a good thing, you know, when you come into the house of the Lord, so that you could do what you need to do, which is to give him praise. Praise God. I said, I will take heed to my ways, that I sin not with my tongue. I will keep my mouth with a bridle while the wicked is before me. I was dumb with silence. I held my peace even from good, and my sorrow was still. My heart was hot within me while I was musing, the fire burned. Then spake I with my tongue, Lord, make me to know mine end and the measure of my days, what it is, that I may know how frail I am. Behold, thou hast made my days as a handbreadth, and my age is as nothing before thee. Verily, every man at his best state is altogether vanity, Selah. And for the children that is among us, the meaning of Selah means say it again. Yes. Surely every man walketh in a vain show. Surely they are disquieted in vain. He heapeth up riches and knoweth not who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what wait I for? My hope is in thee. Deliver me from all my transgressions. Make me not the reproach of the foolish. I was dumb. I opened not my mouth, because thou didst it. Remove thy stroke away from me. I am consumed by the blow of thine hand. When thou hast rebuked, dost correct man for iniquity, thou makest his beauty to consume away like a moth. Surely every man is vanity, Selah. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and give ear unto my cry. Hold not thy peace at my tears, for I am a stranger with thee, and a sojourner as all my fathers were. Spare me, that I may recover strength before I go hence and be no more. Here ended the lesson of the 39th Psalm. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Is there another director wishing to bring the second lesson for me? If not, I will proceed.
Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hadst formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, Return ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday, when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as they sleep in the morning. They are like the grass which grows up. In the morning it flourishes and grows up. In the evening it is cut down and withers. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thine wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our inequalities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy contentment. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years, and if by reason of strength, they are these 80 years. Yet is the strength, labor, and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let us repent be concerning thy servants. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. May us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us, and the years wherein we have seen evil. Let thy will appear unto thy servants, and thy glory unto their children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us. Yea, the work of our hands establish thou, thou be it.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever. Gospel of John, the 14th chapter, verses 1 through to 7. Here it's starting from the very first verse. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know it whether thou goest, how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If he had known me, he should have known my Father also, and from henceforth he knew him and have seen him. Resting in the 7th verse, giving God the adoration and praise. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. At this point in time, the eulogy is about to be read by... What's the name? It's Christopher, I think. Just come in. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I see the sun, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed, and sings my soul.
Today I'll be giving the eulogy. Short and simple and sweet. Okay, so the word speed, that's the distance traveled per unit of time. It's how fast someone or something move. Speed is the first word that I can use to describe Junior Patrick Palin. He was conceived by deceased Ollie Patrick Allen and deceased Gemma Howell. Born December 6, 1960. He was a known funeral director, the founder of A.J. Nella's funeral home. He born in the district, in the vicinity of Tunaputna. Later, he grew up in Sandy Grande. Then he came back to Tunaputna, then to Sawa, and as my friend. He was gifted both spiritually and materialistically. He generously gave huge charities to families, friends, communities. A very popular guy, a man of the law. Being raised by such an awesome dad, life was full of excitement. There was never a dull moment. Although known to be eccentric, he was a magnificent father. He was stern, he properly disciplined his children, instilling qualities of love, generosity, compassion, honesty, humility for people in our hearts. A master strategist who imperceptibly observed people and knew the most lucrative move, like a game of chess. He loved teaching us business and ensured that we all pursued our education. He loved family time and took us to beaches and rivers where we cooked, drank, played music, danced, talked, and laughed. He was indeed an adventurous guy, a man who has traveled the world. He loved life and enjoyed everything that life had to offer without any regrets. Junior peacefully departed on Saturday, the 25th of July, 2020. After spending quality time with his family, he is now resting peacefully. May the Almighty God guide his soul to eternal rest. Thank you.
At this point in time, we're about to have some tributes. So I want to give way maybe to some of the directors who are here, that you can come. You don't need to come on the stage if you don't want to climb up. I'll hand it right to you down there, and you'll say two words, and then we move on. People who wish you to come and say something. Thank you. And when I take that body, son, not spirit, send him to die, I scarce can take it.
Feel like forever, night's all.
You may not feel it. You're not alone.
Did what he had to do, and he did it his way. We don't pick no bones about it because he dared you try to talk everything good. Now that wasn't easy. All you know that. He was a good old cross when he went in. You know. But at the end of the day, Junior is Junior. One thing you couldn't take from him was his ability to make things happen. He did business, you know. You could do what you want. As you always say, my fridge will always be full. And it wasn't with cold beers. He buy that outside. He had it full with bodies. He did what he had to do, a gifted man in what he did. And he left a legacy, I want to believe. And when I say wealth, his name itself would go on. And those who follow after him, especially those of his children, if they would come together, they don't have to change that name. That name has weight with it and is going to carry them a long way at the end of the day. The only thing is make sure you have his standards in doing things. Once you have his standards in doing things, now let's not get on like a real But when he's dealing with people to bury a dead, you don't believe it's the same person, you know. Very gentle, very nice, well spoken, ensure that you get through. Why? At the end of the day, it was his job and he made no bones about it. I have known people in the Peter that says, when my father there and my sister and them there, let us bury them for free. You know, he did his thing. And he lived his life. The last thing I heard is one of his sons was saying to me that when he was in the hospital, he said, I'm not dead in no hospital, you know. I want to go home. I want to dead on my couch. I don't know if he got his wish. He went home. Now that just goes to show something, eh? He was not scared of death. Now everybody, some people deal with funerals and bury dead. But when death started to come too close to home, they can't handle it. I believe the junior made his mind up. He knew that his time was coming and he prepared himself to go home. And at the end of the day, he's going home. We all wish the best for those that we love. We will all wish the best for those that we love. And sometimes those that we love have hurt us in the past. And because there is love in us, we will still wish the best for those who have passed. And we pray that he would find that peace, that transition with God. Scripture says, and it says it well, 70 if by reason of strength they be forced 4 years. But you know when people hear Nella's gone, you know what they say? He's about 70 or 75, 80. Say, no, he's only 60. What? Sometimes our name exceeds our age. Because he was out there, people believe that, you know, he was this old man. He was quite young at the age of 60. He went home. People say, well, he knows how to live. That's not true. Jesus died until the 33. He was a really young man. Age, the factor of age and longevity is one thing. But you can live long and you live like an old cross and you're dead like an old cross. You have no part with God, you know. People can come and bawl and faint in your funeral and roll all on your graveside. If you did not make peace with God, forget it. And you may die at a young age, but you have lived a life virtuous in the sight of your Creator. When you go home, people say, well, boy, you know, she gone home. And look how young she gone home. But God called her home first, and God knew why. Junior was sick. He knew he was sick, and he was ready. This I say to you, the worst kind of death is not a sickness, you know. No. When you have pain, Scripture says, Lord, I am happy. I was glad when thou hast afflicted me, that I will remember thy law. In sickness, you can make peace and you can make the amends with God. With sudden death, sometimes you just finish cussing the neighbor good and proper, and you have the neighbor in mind, and you may die in your sleep at night. You may have to answer for that which you have carried as a baggage. Junior coil now, cussing now, and 2 minutes time you come back and see him. And I keep reading cussing. Remember time you do me something and I get mad. So when they call me back to do the funeral, I say, I ain't coming over. I say, no, I ain't got time. Meet me this Saturday. Never curse me, never. God is my judge, you never curse me. Say, we want, you are young girl, you want all over. And I just watching Junior. Charlie's no witness, Charlie was walking with me. And I watched him and he said, man. I said, he go talk to me again. But we met up somewhere, he's had a funeral, and we met to say, how are you going? I spoke with him, he was cool, a cool thing. That was the man, that is who he was at the end. But his life is an open book. And there are pages you would read and smile and want to read again. And there are some pages in which you could either skip or tear out. But you can't. It's Junior. You have to read the whole book. If the minute you decide to take out any page from his book of life, you have spoiled the book. The good, the bad, and the indifference is all there. And some people always look at things in a dumb way, but look at things to elevate you. If your father did wrong, and you knew your father did wrong, why in God's name, when you grew up in that sense, knowing your father did wrong, that you will continue to do wrong? You try to do right. If your father made mistakes, you would try not to make the same mistakes. But many of us would look and blame, and we always play the blame game. From since Adam to now, we're still blaming. You see, it's only because you call me out and bounce my foot. Why did Steve or me didn't want to come out of the world if I call you? And we all play this blame game, and many of us will not see that it is God who is calling us. Junior died down there, and he did his thing. Believe you me, he was a brave man. And because he knew what to do in his field of work, he was not afraid. I remember when he came back from the States. Junior came back and Junior just started everything. I see how Junior handled bodies. I said, marvel at him how he did it. Is when I spoke to Nigel, and Nigel said, there is a secret we have. And we can keep that. We can do this without any eyes for this amount of period, and nothing can happen to the body. So you serious? He said, yes. And I've seen Junior display that when little was handed to him, when he was now billing back. How he handled it. He went back to basics, and if you see how he handled it, beautifully. He rised again, but in this rising, it is his period now that he would make his transition. His transition unto the Most High. As you mourn him, I ask of you, remember him. You know, we all have a saying, we can't pray for the dead, because the dead is already dead. But the old school says that sometimes you need to throw two words of prayer for the dead who are there. Lord, remember my father. Remember my son. Because those who have died in Christ only fall asleep. And there is a place, as the scripture says, I go now to prepare a place for you, that where I am, he may be also. And the saints read it in that place. Then we throw two words of prayer, we ask God to be merciful unto those who have passed. That's why the old people in the 49th, the 39th night, the 39th day before the 49th, the old people used to cook food and give it to the poor, and share to the poor. On the 40th day, they would do the prayers that God would be appeased for the charity you have done on behalf of those who have passed. We pray that all will be well. This is a time where someone mourn. Now the kids will all laugh and be strong now, you know. I went down when it was. It was Tuesday night, I went down to do a little prayer for them. They all were there. If you hear the stories, I'm talking about less than 20 minutes, you get some stories there. You could write a book, you know. Everybody talk from the cotton they get to the hour there they get up in the morning. And if you hear the stories, and they all, I'm going to say they were lying, you know. One started, and if one forget where it is, the next one finish it for you. And you could have listened to them, and all they had was saying is what their father was, how strict he was, and what he encouraged them to do. That's good, and that's real. We pray that he would find his peace with God. We pray that all will be well with his soul at the end of the day. Because let me tell you something. To build a big empire and enjoy the best in life, give those who have not and have done all that you want to do and God has blessed you to give you time to make peace with him, and you're still in all of that and is far wanted with God, that'll be a real flop, you know. Imagine you could have slept in the best hotels you want. Carry your kids to any part of the world they want. Give them the best that you had. You had a good life. You did good, you did bad, you did the indifferent. Still yet God's mercy extend to you. And you choose to throw that away. Not even the devil will laugh at you. You see, you are real clown. Imagine the devil call you a clown. He had his time. God has blessed him to take him out in his way. And we pray, and that's my, I don't want to know nothing else. All I want to hear is that at his last hour, coming up to his last hour, Junior Patrick Allen, the director of Netherlands, have made peace with God. I don't want to know nothing else. If you owe anybody here, I don't want it to get, look at me. So don't come and ask nobody. Son to them just like him, so don't bother to tackle them, leave them alone. But I'm saying to you, at the end of the day, that's my hope for him. he have made peace with God. That's why we are here. If we're here for something else, I can go home quiet and comfortable. You hear me? But I'm here because I believe there is hope. And there is a time that we will all rise. Imagine you're the funeral director. There be so much of people when you go down there. Them say who you, them may know you and they like you. Understand it well. We pray God that he will find his peace and his transition with God. Truly may God be merciful unto us. May he cause his peace to shine upon us. So beloved, with these few words, let us all sing Jerusalem, my happy home. But see that.
Really?
all right, at this point in time. To those who have spoken to you, you guys come in front of me to this last ceremony over the body. With Lacqua, I saw Lacqua was here just now. Where is he? With Charlie, oh, I just see Charlie sit up somewhere here. Where is him? There's another there, somebody. Mr. Allen, could you come, sir? Wait a second. Hey, hi. The last hymn there is Jerusalem, my happy home. If you sing that to me, we'll all follow you. Sing it. I had no key, there's no bars. Huh? Alright, let's see how we go on. Right. Olive, come up a little bit more. Here, come up. Where's Nigel? Call Nigel, one second. Then I'm ready to sing it sound. Let's just raise our right hands over the coffin and bow our heads and repeat the Our Father prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters, restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness against me. Yea, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil and my cup with oil. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me in the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let God arise and all his enemies be scattered. Let God arise and all his enemies be scattered. Let God arise and all his enemies be scattered. Grant us a safe passage for one who is in the Patrick Allen, I ask thee. Grant safe passage for all for one who is in Patrick Allen. Let us all put for the cousin or the period sentence to go from one another and we'll be everything after, right? Very good. Do everything as I do here. Put your hands on the shoulder like this before you carry it. Sing for me, my lady. Oh Lord, my God.
I In you I can be strong. I look to
Yeah.